What's up, y'all? Today, I'm going to show y'all how we boil crawfish in Southeast Louisiana. First, you're going to need a burner, an 80 to 100 gallon pot, and you're going to need a full tank. And these are some of the other ingredients that you're going to need to complete this crawfish boil. It comes out to about $50. All right, so the first thing you're going to need to do is you have to wash those crawfish. They're called mud bugs for a reason. They need to be washed. All the mud needs to be taken off of them. You can see all the mud right there. Wash them again if they're not clean enough after that first round. Then fight the crawfish. Just kidding. Don't call PETA on me. All right, cut your onions in half. Then you're going to cut all of your lemons in half. And then cut your sausage into about 2-inch pieces. That usually makes for a good bite size once it's cooked down. So that'll be good. Cut your oranges in half. Don't know why I cut them like that. Cut your garlic in half. I actually put in more garlic than that, than is shown in the video. And then leave your mushrooms whole. They're going to soak up all those spices inside of that boil. So here are all the ingredients after we cut up everything. Next, fill up the pot about a third to halfway full. I filled it up a little bit too much, but it's okay. Turn on the propane, light it, and then open up your regulator full blast so it's got the most fire you can possibly see, as shown below. All right, then you're going to wait until the water gets lukewarm, and then you're going to add in your seasoning. I use Cajun Land. It's a 4.5-pound bucket, and it works perfect. And then I add a 12-ounce of liquid boil that adds so much flavor to the boil. So you stir that, and then you're going to start adding in your ingredients. So you squeeze all of your lemons, add your onions, add your celery that's been chopped, and then you give that a good stir. Next, you're going to bring that up to a higher temperature, and then you're going to add all of your potatoes that you have because they take longer to cook than everything else. So you're going to cover that, and then you're going to bring that to a rolling boil. All right, so this is where the magic happens. You got to pour all your crawfish into the boiling water. Make sure they all get covered by all that water. Give it a good stir to make sure they're all covered. And now you're going to add some of the fixings that take about the same time to cook as the rest of your crawfish. So add your sausage, add your mushrooms, and whatever other fixings that you want. So stir that in there. Don't forget to bless that pot with a whole beer. Cooks deserve to drink a beer while they cook. Cover that, bring it back to a boil, and look at this. Oh my God, that looks amazing. That's getting close, and then you cut off your gas as soon as it comes back up to a boil. And this is where you're going to stop the internal heat that's in the middle of that boil. So you pour the frozen corn in there, and you push it down. And I like to use frozen water bottles to push down towards the middle to help lower that internal temperature. Next, you're going to squeeze those 4 pieces of orange, and it gets a good citrus flavor added onto the top, and it just adds overall just an awesome flavor to your crawfish. It's a great addition. Stir that in. Now, after about 30 to 40 minutes, you taste a few, and if they're at your preferred spice level, then you start taking it out and you let that thing drain. And for the finale, you pull your crawfish out into a boat or on a table covered in newspaper, and it's ready to enjoy, man. Look how good that looks. A sack can feed anywhere from 6 to 10 people, depending on who's eating. But this is how you open up a crawfish. You peel off the head, you peel off a few layers of the tail, pull out the meat, and you enjoy. Damn, that's good.